Long time ago, people used the barter system to trade goods and services. Here you can see examples like a person giving chicken in exchange for rice, milk for eggs, plants or toys for rice, different types of vegetables being exchanged. But as time passed, money was introduced, making trade much easier. Today, every country has its own currency. Hello everyone, this is Usha here. Let's explore the fascinating world of money together and solve all types of fun questions about it. I'll use Indian currency in my examples. However, you can imagine them as your own country's currency because the basics are the same. In different countries, currencies have different names, but they all follow a similar pattern. 1 pound is equal to 100 pence. 1 Singapore dollar is equal to 100 cents. 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. And 1 US dollar is equal to 100 cents. Rupee is denoted like this and dollar this way. The values are different according to each country's economy. That is how much money a country has and how people use that money to buy and sell things. So, let's begin this exciting journey of learning about money. After the barter trade system, people started using coins made of metal. These coins were difficult to carry because they were heavy. So, paper currency was introduced. It's made using special paper and is much easier to carry. Now, as you all know, payments have become digital using cards and mobile phones. But let's go back to the basics. Do you know how many different coins and notes we use in our daily life? Let's explore. Here are some specimen coins and notes from India. The year printed on each coin and note of the same denomination can be different. This indicates the year they came into circulation. Many things are printed on notes such as value, a picture, and sometimes a signature. Some coins are no longer in use because their value is very low, like 25 paise and 50 paise coins. Here is a helpful table to understand the relationship between rupees and paise. 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. 4 25 paise coins is equal to 1 rupee, that is 100 paise. 2 50 paise coins is again equal to 1 rupee, which is 100 paise. Here is an activity for you. Observe some coins and notes and write down what you see on each one. Making a given amount. As I said before, we shall use only one currency to avoid confusion. You can imagine it to be your country's currency. Numerically, they are the same, though their exchange values are different and also keep changing. You will learn more about that in higher classes. Make the given amount using coins of the same denomination. Now here you have some 1 rupee coins. The question is, circle the correct number of coins to make the amount of money shown. So this is it. So there are 7 1 rupee coins here, 7 rupees. One more example, make the given amount. How much is that? 20 rupees. So you will take 4 5 rupee coins, which will give you 20 rupees. Next is, make the given amount using coins of different denomination. The question here is, Rahul has 1 5 rupee coin, 3 2 rupee coins and 5 1 rupee coins. Give 2 different combinations to make rupees 10 using the coin shown below. The first combination is, you can take like this, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Second combination you can have like this, 5 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1. Next is counting piggy bank money. Here you have one piggy bank which belongs to Rinku and another one which belongs to Pinky. Count the money in Rinku's and Pinky's piggy bank. So money in Rinku's piggy bank is 5 plus 5 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 15, and in Pinky's it is 5 + 5 + 2 + 2 + 1 + 5, which is equal to 20. Now who has more money? Pinky has more money. Now here one mother is teaching her son how to put money in piggy bank. Learn to save money in piggy bank. Here is a vegetable market with fruits, vegetables and so many things, and you have to read the price tags and buy certain items. I'll show you some few vegetables here. You have to name the costliest vegetable among these. Pumpkin costing 40 rupees, brinjal 12, capsicum 20 and tomato 15. Out of this, the costliest is the pumpkin. Next, Pinky's mother gave her rupees 50 to buy fruits. She bought one pineapple and one mango. What is the total cost of the two fruits? How much money did the shopkeeper return to her? Now here are the fruits with their prices. Mango 20 rupees, pear 5 rupees, pineapple 15 rupees and cashew fruit 12 rupees. She is buying one pineapple and one mango. That is 15 rupees plus 20 rupees. That is 35 rupees. She gives 50 rupees to the shopkeeper, so how much does he return to her? 50 minus 35, which is equal to 15. To estimate the prices of different items, you can visit places like malls, hotels, restaurants, bookstores with elders. Note the prices of different items you see there. Discuss your findings with your friends to compare prices. Estimating prices helps you understand the value of money. Here you can see banks, two banks. A bank is a safe place to keep your money. You can deposit money into your bank account. This means putting your money in the bank for future use. Whenever you need your money, you can withdraw it from the bank. Withdrawing money allows you to use your savings when needed. Banks help manage your money safely and securely. Here are some word problems with money. Solve these word problems to become a money expert. A mother gave her child rupees 15 to put in the piggy bank. The child already had rupees 30 in the piggy bank. How much money is there in the piggy bank now? So you have to add both. Rohan buys a pencil for rupees 20 and a sharpener for rupees 15. How much money does he spend in total? That is, you have to add 20 and 15. John bought two books for rupees 15. Then he found a sale and got another book for rupees 5. If he had rupees 25 at the start, how much money does he have left now? So you have to add 15 and 5, that is 20, and you have to subtract 25 minus 20. Sam goes to a shop to buy a chocolate. The cost of the chocolate he wants to buy is rupees 15, but he has only rupees 10 with him. How much more money does he need to buy the chocolate? So what have you to do? Subtract. This is the chocolate. Now the last question, how much money does Arya have if she has 3 coins of 10 and 1 20 rupees coin? You have to add all this. You have learned so much about money today. Keep practicing and become a money expert. Stay tuned for my next video and see you next time. Bye. Take care.